بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حم والكتاب المبين إن مباركة إنا كنا منذرين إن إنا أنزلناه في ليلة مباركة إنا كنا منذرين
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. Today's ayah is a beautiful ayah. It is the third ayah in Surah Al-Dukhan, chapter number 44. In this ayah, the Almighty Allah confirms, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakah. Inna kunna munzirin. Let me begin by explaining that the pronoun inna, which is plural, we, this is the royal we. Allah is one. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحْدٌ. Whenever he says inna, this is a reference to the royal we. The Almighty Allah is the greatest. If the kings, the prime ministers, and the big officers of the dunya, they say, we decided, we've done this, then the Almighty Allah is most worthy of saying using the royal we. Not that Allah is more than one. In Quran, inna refers to the royal we. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. Most certainly, we sent it down during a blessed night. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakah. Indeed, we sent it down on a blessed night. Inna kunna munzirin. Indeed, we were to warn mankind thereof. This ayah was not the only ayah in the Quran in reference to the revelation of the glorious Quran. أنزلناه, the pronoun refers to the glorious Quran. And that is what is mentioned in the beginning of Surah Al-Dukhan. You also find an entire chapter, which is known as Surah Al-Qadr. The Almighty Allah begins this chapter by saying, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. Most certainly, we've sent it down on the grand night, Al-Qadr. And Al-Qadr is different than Al-Qadr. Al-Qadr means the great value, the grand, while Al-Qadr refers to the preordainment, the divine destiny, and so on. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. That night on which the Quran's revelation started off is better than 1,000 months. That explains why the Almighty Allah said in Surah Al-Dukhan, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ. On a blessed night. And then we find in ayah number 183, chapter number 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, the Almighty Allah talks about in ayah number 185, chapter number 2, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of the Ramadan, the month of Ramadan, on which the Quran was revealed. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. So wait a minute. Was the Quran revealed in the month of Ramadan or ليلة مباركة or ليلة القدر? And wait a minute. Was the Quran revealed entirely on one night or in one month? What is it exactly? The beginning of the revelation of the Quran to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when he was in the cave, was in a blessed night. And that blessed night was one of the nights of the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. And it was only the beginning. But the Quran, as an entire book, was sent down by the Almighty Allah to what is known as Baytul Izzah, that is deposited in the worldly heaven. And from there, the Almighty Allah would order Gabriel, peace be upon him, to reveal to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, segments, ayahs, chapters of the Quran, answers to questions, new rules and regulations, legislations, until the revelation of the Quran was completed right before the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this process lasted for 23 years. So when you hear inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakah, it means the revelation of the Quran started off on a blessed night. And it has become blessed because Allah the Almighty chose that night to begin the revelation of the greatest message ever, the glorious Quran, the miracle of all miracles. And then Allah the Almighty has decided that night of every year, it is Laylatul Qadr, on which the Almighty Allah will reveal to the angels of the ordainment which need to be taken care of the upcoming year. The birth, the death, the sickness, the provision, the cure, everything. فيها يفرق كل أمر حكيم. Everything will be decided on that night. The Almighty Allah has already pre-decided all of that. In the hadith, the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, indeed, the Almighty Allah has decided the preordainment of all the creatures 50,000 years before the creation of the heavens and the earth. Then every year, on Laylatul Qadr, the Almighty Allah will reveal to them what needs to be executed. And every angel knows exactly what they need to do for the upcoming year. That's why it's Laylatul Mubarakah and it is Laylatul Qadr. Because of that, the Almighty Allah made its worship is better than the worship that is done over a period of 1,000 months, that is 83 years and a couple months of continuous worship. One single night from sunset till dawn. Whoever happens to worship the Almighty Allah by any means of worship, the prayers, night prayer, taraweeh, tahajjud, recitation of Quran, supplication, or dhikr, especially for those who cannot pray because of the menses, like the sisters during their menses, their worship during this blessed night before Allah is better than a worship that is observed in 83 years and a couple months continuously. Inna kunna munzirin, the Almighty Allah ever delivers the teachings and the warning, the guidance and the warning. If you refuse it, then he has already informed you the fate of those who refuse this message. May the Almighty Allah enable us to witness many nights of Laylatul Qadr and observe them with the best acts of worship. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.